Pete Moriarty here. Great to have you. We are doing another Google Workspace updates. This is our place on the channel where we go through all the latest updates to Google Workspace, give you a little bit of a rundown of what's new in the Google world. So if you're new to the channel, my name is Pete Moriarty, and we help organizations and businesses systemize, organize, and scale using Google Workspace and other technology tools as well. And we're really passionate about finding that middle ground between technology and strategy and business and bringing those all together to build more successful businesses. Now, with specifically Google Workspace, we really love implementing that into businesses because it's a very scalable ecosystem. And anyone who's already using Google Workspace knows that it's really easy to use, but there's also a lot of features as well. And you may not get around to everything that Google releases in the feature updates. I've already highlighted, I think in front of me, about 8 or 9 different features just in the last month that have been released. And these are my top picks out of everything that Google's updated in the last month. Now, Google publishes a update to their blog every time there's an update in the Google Workspace world. But they can go a little bit overboard with all of the intricate updates in there. And unless you're a full-time IT admin, you probably wouldn't bother reading every single one. So I'm going to summarize my favorite ones over the last month and share those with you. So the first one we're going to jump into is inside Google Spaces, which is basically our chat rooms. You can now actually have the space manager, which is the person with the little green triangle next to their name. That's the space manager. That person actually now has permission to delete any messages that are inside the space, which is pretty useful. So I've got a space here with my team. Let's go and open it up. And so inside any spaces here, you can see someone will sometimes have a little green icon there on their name. And if I go and open up, gotta be careful I don't share anything here. But you can see there the space manager is the person with a little green thing next to them. And basically that space manager is the person who has the ability to add and remove people from the space, but they can also now delete chat messages, which is pretty cool. So if you've got like a big group chat and you've got like your whole team in there and someone says something, you know, stupid or inappropriate, that might be a reason why you might want to use that. Yeah, but very, very cool little feature. Google's now giving a few more admin controls. What I'm glad to see is that Google obviously have a team still working on chat. You know, in the past, they'd kind of like launch something and then not really bother updating it or doing anything else with it. Now, what this is showing is that Google's actually committed to continuing to develop the product, which is really good. It's really good to see. We don't want any products kind of disappearing, going by the wayside. Okay, so next up is an update to companion mode. And so you can now share your video feed when you're in companion mode. Now, I'm not sure why you would want to do this. If you're not familiar with companion mode is a very cool feature. What it actually lets you do is join a meeting from your laptop, but it effectively doesn't bring your microphone and doesn't bring your camera in. And what that's really useful for is, let's say you've got like a meeting room set up, or you've got maybe you're using an iPad or a secondary device to join a meeting. You want to have another device ready for you to either make notes on or share a presentation. And I use this all the time. Sometimes I travel in a camper truck and I'll do my meetings like on my mobile phone or on an iPad sitting in a tripod. And then I'll use companion mode to join the meeting. And when I join the meeting, it will give me a little option there to use companion mode. And effectively it lets you join without camera or microphone. And you can share, you can participate in chat, can participate in polls and all the other features that are in there, which is really cool. You can see all the participants, you can highlight different participants, but you know, it doesn't share anything. What that solves is the problem of having feedback coming through if you were to join a meeting twice. Now, the solution to that I used to do when I joined from a second device is just mute myself, switch off my camera, and then I'd turn off the volume on my computer and it would work fine. But Google's made like the dummies version of joining from a second device, and that's called companion mode. Now, what's changed here is Google have basically said, okay, well, if you want to bring your camera in, but obviously not audio, you can now bring your camera into companion mode. I can't think of a scenario where I would want to do that because I'm usually already on another screen, either with a Google Meet hardware device or I've got, you know, like another screen with my actual camera there. But for whatever reason, you can now do that. So lucky you can now bring your camera in. Cool. All right, let's move on to the next one. So Google now let you bring in table templates and drop down chips into Google Docs. This is a pretty interesting feature. I'm really interested to see where Google are going with this. What they're now basically letting you do is build out more and more and more options inside your Google Docs with dynamic content. So you can see here you've got drop downs. And what that reminds me of is something like monday.com or Asana. They're effectively starting to give you more dynamic data living right inside your Google documents. Now, why would you want to have that in a Google Doc? Why would you not just use Trello or Asana or Monday or something else for it? I don't know. But for some people who like to do tasks inside documents, I think it's nuts. But for some people who do like to do tasks inside documents, you may choose to use this feature. I don't know. Let me know in the comments if you think this is going to be useful or not. Definitely big moves that Google's making in the documents. And I covered last time the email drafting. I think that one's pretty useful. I can't see a use case for this just yet if you do happen to be using other task-based management tools. But yeah, but let me know. Either way, maybe there is something there that's useful. All right, next up, what do we got next? Okay, so this is a admin console policy, and this one's related to storage. So what this allows you to do now, if you go into the storage menu in your workspace admin, you can actually see who's using what storage. You can also choose, you know, there's different storage settings and there's some policies around that. But one of the most useful things is Google's made it really, really easy to see who is using what. So you can see here, you've got your top users who may be using storage in their individual accounts, and then you've got your shared drives that are using the storage as well. Now, up until recently, this just didn't matter at all. You pretty much had unlimited storage. If you're a business, you'd definitely be on one of the business plans, and then you'd effectively have unlimited storage for your Google account. But Google has now changed, and your storage counts per user. So you get 1 terabyte per user if you're on a business account or above on Google Workspace, and that's going to start accounting. So you need to now be mindful and start to think about who's using what inside your business and be careful that the space doesn't fill up. So thank you, Google. Big thumbs up. Nice, easy report to see where everything is used there. Okay, next up, we have an update to hardware kits. Zeus have sent out an updated kit for Google Meet. You can see there's a few different options here. These come with the speaker mic, which are really, really great. Those speaker mics basically let you hear everyone in a small meeting room or in a boardroom. You can even link up multiple together, which is really cool. And these are just phenomenal, phenomenal devices. Any Google Meet hardware, there's a few different ways of getting access to Google Meet hardware, but these are just absolutely phenomenal devices. They turn any meeting room into a powerhouse. And I love these. I even have one of these set up at home, so I can just click one button and jump straight into meetings. And I used to have it just sitting in front of the couch, so I could sit on the couch with a laptop and have my Google Meet there where I could jump straight in. Now, if you have any kind of hybrid office type setup where you have an actual office setup or you have a dedicated office with dedicated boardrooms, you've got to jump onto Google Meet hardware kits. They are excellent. If you're interested, we are a reseller, so you can reach out to our team and help out with pricing and supply. Okay, next up, we have some updates to Google Sheets. And here we actually have context-aware corrections inside Google Sheets. And so context-aware suggestions, you can see there, it's suggesting a new formula. They're actually going to look not just at the immediate cell, but also around the context of your document as well. And if you've ever gone to try and create a formula and got a suggested formula from Google, and with one of those, you know, suggested formulas, just have it not work and you've had to go in and you know, fix and kind of clean things up manually, this makes your life very, very easy. It makes it much easier than trying to do it. So Google is starting to bring their AI into everywhere that we are working. And I've said many times, you know, inside of Google Sheets, we have the Insights tab. And on that Insights tab, you can click a button and it's using AI to automatically, you know, create graphs and suggest pivot tables and all those kind of things for you. We are not far away from the moment that Google decides to enable voice for their spreadsheets. And what will happen at that point, very likely, is that we'll just literally be able to talk to our spreadsheet, ask it data, and have that information coming straight back to us. And that's just like, you know, something like Minority Report, where we're literally working with the computer and, you know, the computer is doing absolutely everything for us. So very, very, very cool stuff coming up there. Next update is Google Sites is getting the ability to have company-wide themes, and you can actually import themes from a company library. Now, our organization is not big enough, even though we've got 50, 60 people, we're not quite big enough that we're creating sites every day of the week. But if you are in a larger organization, you might be the kind of business where you're encouraging team members to create intranets, and this would be a pretty useful feature for you. So you can make sure that the branding stays based on your company branding. So you can create a theme and submit it, I assume, to some kind of theme library. And then from there, you can effectively publish that to the team and they'll be able to, you know, import and work with that theme anytime they're launching a new site. Great one, Google. That's going to be really useful, particularly for large organizations that want to keep everything consistent. Okay, next one is a search feature, and this is inside Google Drive. Probably not useful unless you're doing a lot of meetings, but you can now run a search parameter and search for Google Meet content inside of Google Drive. And so if you're interested in doing that, what it will allow you to do is search for all of these different bits of information, meeting recordings, chat transcripts. Basically, all of that is going to be available inside your Google Drive. And if you search their app and then Google Meet, that's the operator, it's going to bring up everything. Now, what you may find this useful for is if you had a previous meeting and you say, you know what, that I'm sure that was said in that meeting somewhere, or I'm sure somebody mentioned that. The great thing about this is anytime you have like a calendar event and you attach something, it's going to show up in the meeting and become a meeting document. And Google search will actually even go into, it will go inside PDFs inside your Google Drive. So the search is very, very intelligent, goes quite deep as well. And so this would be an opportunity, I think, if you've had a meeting, you're not quite sure exactly what was shared in the meeting, but you want to go and find the documents and the resources related to it, you can go ahead and open that and you can see you don't have to be the owner of those files. It will also search other people's files as well. So finally, we've got updates to Google Calendar in sharing your work location. I really, really love this feature because, well, you know, while we're all working remotely now, we may as well have all of our team member knowing where we're up to, if we're in the office, if we're out of the office, if we're on holidays, if we're working from the road, if we're working from a mobile phone in a park. We want to have our team know where we're at so we can actually work together efficiently. So Google allows you to set your work location right inside your calendar, which makes it nice and simple for you to keep your team updated on where things are at. So if I go ahead to my calendar here, you can see I've actually updated mine to truck because, well, not today in the truck, actually, it's going to be from next week forward. I'm working in the truck. But let's say, for example, if on Fridays you're working from home, you can select home there and you can choose if it's just one Friday or all Fridays. So I'm actually going to change my truck here to home today, this Thursday. There we go. And you can see it's automatically in home, but it should keep my next week. There we go. Still in the truck. I'm going to be on holidays and broadcasting from the road. And so you can see it's automatically put that there in the right place. If you're not yet registered for our Workspace Bootcamp, please make sure you head to our website and check that out. There will be a link down below this video as well, so you can go straight there. That is where you can get access to you and your team, the basic knowledge, but also the genius steps in making sure you've got everything you need to know about the Google Workspace ecosystem sorted for you and your business. Now, we want to help everyone in the Google Workspace world get to superstar level, but as you know, sometimes there are many, many options and buttons and settings, and you don't quite know what all the best ones are for your business. Well, we're going to take you through all the basics of Mail, Calendar, Drive, Chat, Meet, Admin Panel, saving your passwords, and we're going to take you through everything that we wish every one of our customers has done right. There's many customers that work with us and they buy concierge and we, you know, consult to their businesses and do a big health check and go deep with them. But many, many more customers who maybe just have their billing with us, or if you are a subscriber to our YouTube channel and you're not yet doing business with us, well, the bootcamp is a great way to start and a great way to make sure that you and your team have everything that you need to know with Google Workspace. So click on the link below, check out that bootcamp. It's gonna be great. It's coming up within the next month, so make sure you jump on and grab a ticket to those. They are limited, but we've made them a very affordable price, and you can bring two staff members along as well. What I would recommend is you and your team have one or two people in there who are delegated as your Google experts within the business, and then they can be the go-to person. So we're gonna be learning about shared mailboxes. We're gonna be checking your DNS and making sure that's all set up correctly. We're gonna make sure you and your team have your sharing settings correct. We're going to jump into your Google Drive and make sure everything's nice and tidy there. We're going to be talking about backup and data archiving. I'm just basically going to be taking you through all of my top tips and tricks. Rather than going and watching 100 videos on our YouTube channel, I'm going to be in there implementing with you in the room. So if you're interested in that, jump on any of the links on our socials and you'll find it. Otherwise, you'll find it on our website, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks so much for joining, and I'll catch you next time. Cheers.